Awo, shalom, Rastafari. Okay, we're still in this sabbatical week of the Shabbat portion. This particular Torah portion, as you should be familiar with, is Vayera or Vayera, which means and he revealed. Now, what we want to introduce before we get into another part of this, before we have to begin our new Torah portion, is this most recent publication, BEREISHITH, and this right here is the Hebrew book of Genesis. It's a compilation, some of the online compilation and other information out there concerning the weekly Torah portions from the book of Genesis are compiled in here. And although we have a disclaimer on this this volume, and we're still in this particular volume, as you can see from a consultation with our Torah portions, we are about to approach between the fourth and the fifth week. And the fourth week, Bamarinya, and the Amharic is Tegelet. The Hebrew is Vayera or Vayera, and he revealed. And coming up in about a day or so is the fifth Torah portion. And the fifth Torah portion is, in the Hebrew, is known as Haye Sara or Haye Sara. And that is concerning Saram or Sharam Idme, concerning the life or the age of Sarah, our mother or our Hebrew matriarch. But we're still in the fourth Sabbath Torah portion, reading and feeding, and we just wanted to, this is a pretty thick volume here, and the disclaimer is that the views presented in this particular volume are not necessarily, are not our own, and do not necessarily reflect the Ethiopian Hebraic interpretation of the Old Testament or the Ethiopic or Rit Torah in particular, but is being compiled. We're intending to compile five volumes to go along for five portions of, or the five Torah portions, namely Genesis, Bereshit, Exodus, Shemot, Vayikra, Leviticus, Midbar, Numbers, and Devarim or Devarim, which is Deuteronomy. And we're going to print them because of the volume, as you can see, because of the thickness of the volume. We're going to seek to print them in five different portions. But now, the value of this is that for many of us as newcomers, it helps to lay out a general overview to each of the matters concerned in each of the Torah portion readings and feedings, mainly from the modern or Eurocentric Judaic Jewish interpretation of it, or the popular, we could say, Western interpretation. But since we are in the West and we have been, you could say, socialized or brought up into a certain predictive programming, in order to break that programming, we have to get familiar with it. So going through each of these teachings and the details is part of the way of us finding out, as they say, how deep the rabbit hole goes. In other words, you know, not to stay in la la land, but let's see exactly what is taught, what is believed, and then allow the Holy Spirit to guide us and weigh and balance, you know, when we look at our own root and our own truth. So we highly recommend these compilations, because the following compilation of each book of the Hebrew Bible's weekly Torah portions are intended as a basic and a preliminary introduction, to so-called modern Judaism, as it presently, that is to say, the current form based predominantly upon the prevailing European Jewish, i.e. the Germanic, Polish tradition, commentary, interpretation, and related studies that collectively are derived from what is called the Babylonian Talmud, as well as the Jewish Talmud, is reflected in some of these compilations. It says also inclusive in these Wikipedia-free encyclopedia references are certain Sephardic and Spanish Jewish alternative points of view to the Torah studies that are highly instructive, especially in our exploration of the wide diversity of possible interpretations that have and greatly continues to define modern Judaism, or what we call the other Jews, or the European version of Judaism. But we're going to begin, and we have begun from that perspective. And then as we have an opportunity, we start to, you know, go into our own sources, such as whether the Kibbutz Neges, the Metaf Kedus, the Octatech is the Ethiopian, you could say so-called Pentateuch, the Octatech, but it contains 8 books and not just the so-called 5 books. So the 5 from Genesis to Deuteronomy, as well as Judges, Joshua, and the book of Ruth, which were contained in the ancient tradition of what was known as Torah, or the root, the foundation, was not based on the 5, but more was based on the 8. And that's also very, very interesting as we explore that as well. But suffice it to say, this is the Torah portion, Volume 1. There's an introduction and a compilation. It's an introduction and compilation by yours truly for the Lineage of Society of His Imperial Majesty and for the Shabbat Keepers, those of y'all who have also been studying with us. We highly recommend these 5 versions, and this is the first. This right here is the first of the 5 versions of the Torah portions, and this is the first book called BEREISHITH, or the Hebrew Genesis, and is composed of 12 portions, including the first, or the self-named Parasha BEREISHITH, or Genesis, the Medjemaria Bamarinya. But we're gonna touch on the Amharic, or the Ethiopic perspective, after these 5 volumes are compiled and complete. So we're gonna utilize this so we can, where possible, fellowship with other Jews or Hebrews and others, and understand, well, why they believe, or what is their reasoning for what they believe, and then to compare and contrast that based on our Ethiopic Hebrew root and truth. So the 12 portions that are contained in this, so this is the first set of readings and feedings in the book of Genesis. Bereshit Noach Leka Lika Vayera Vayera Hane Sara Tolodot Vayitze Vayishlach Vayeshev or Vayeshev Miket Vayigash and Vayeche. And that's what's contained in this particular portion. So when you look at our Sabbatical readings and feedings here from this particular chart that we've been reminding and asking ones to download at their own particular convenience, in order to be able to follow along and study, where this week, the week of the 11th, this week that is currently, this is Thursday right now, and tomorrow will be Friday, just to date this particular recording right here. And coming up on the 8th, or the 18th rather, would be the new series of reading and feeding, or the fifth. So ones who've been asking, where are we right now for our Torah portion readings and feedings? We're at the week of the 11th, and really you can say maybe the week of the 12th, if you count it from the first day in the week. But the Sabbath is what prepares us. There's a wisdom also contained in that as well. So much of this is based on compilations from like the internet and other sources out there, predominantly like the Wikipedia site, as we put the disclaimer that the views contained in there are not necessarily our own, but they allow and enable us as basic newcomers or basic beginners, the Majumeria in the beginning of our readings and feedings, to become familiarized with the basic interpretations, and then on top of that, or in addition to that, or even in some cases besides wrong or misinterpretation that there might be of certain matters, although overall, technically speaking, the Hebrew interpretation of the Bible, or the Jewish interpretation, especially Old Testament, is much better in most cases than the so-called, than most Christian so-called church versions of it, which is almost like a cartoon by comparison. One thing that the OJs or other Jews do, and this is to their credit, is that they really study it and seek to get the real nuance, and on some level scientifically. Now, we understand that racially speaking, there's been a great whitewash, you understand, of the people and personages of the Bible, so forth and so on. And within this version, we even put another disclaimer to apologize in our preface to this. We explain fully in our preface the reasons why we have chosen to compile in five volumes the Torah portion readings from the so-called Eurocentric, the European, or the Germanic, Polish traditions. Why we have chosen to do that, because many will say, well, why don't we just do it from an Ethiopian perspective? Well, first of all, we have to deal with the reality of things the way they are presently. And most of us have been socialized in a Eurocentric, in the so-called world, or the Gentile, under the Gentile dominion. You understand? Except many of us have not really learned Torah or Bible from a Eurocentric or a Gentile. In other words, we have learned it from a so-called Christian, a watered-down, whitewashed, so forth. You understand, we've talked on that almost ad nauseum, so we're not going to go into that again at this present time. But our introductory notes and other notes that have been attached to each of the volumes will explain. So right now what's available is this particular volume, Bereshit, you understand, which is the Torah portion, first book, the Hebrew Genesis, with introductory notes and compilation by yours truly. So please get a copy of this today for yourself and for your family. Shalom Rastafari.